Hi guys. Okay, so this is going to be my second Valentine's Day look that I am filming in the same day. That's why you're going to notice that I'm wearing the exact same outfit. I've just gone and washed my face. Because I've washed my face, I'm really quickly going to just add a little bit of moisturizer because I used soap and I dried my face out really bad because I'm like rushing between everything. What you do to your face, you must do to your neck. I would hate for my face to look one way and then my neck look another. So, I'm a little bit spotty, and that's okay because that's what foundation is for. Okay, so I did a really simple daytime look. I'll make sure to link it below. I'm going to try and post these at the same time today. I'm so sorry it took me so long to film. I am trying to do filming in a different way now where I'm filming everything all at the same time on one day, so I just focus on filming for a span of time. And then perhaps that will allow me to get some sort of a regularity to my channel. I haven't quite figured out my filming schedule. I haven't quite figured out when I'm going to be posting. I'm going to try and figure out all of that within the next month or so. Because I'm trying to become much more regular at my channel, and I have gone away, come back, gone away, come back. So to anybody that has been subscribed since the beginning, I love y'all. Thank you very, very much. For anybody that's new, welcome. Please make sure to hit the subscribe and like buttons if you enjoy this kind of content. At the end of the video, of course, I want to make sure you like it. But other than that, I'm just going to jump right in. I'm going to start my timer because I went ahead and checked the footage of the first version of filming that I did, and that actually worked where I paused at certain points. So I'm just going to go ahead and push start now, and I'm just going to check that throughout the video so that I can make sure that it doesn't eat my footage or I think that it's there and then I go to edit and it's just gone. So to get started, I had just put on some lotion on my face, and it's the Origins Ginseng Energy Boosting Moisturizer. This is what I put on my face every single morning. I just did this after washing my face, just like I do in the mornings, just to give it that extra pop of moisturizer. I am going to be using the Too Faced Born This Way, and it's in the color Light Beige. So I've gone ahead and done my foundation. So that's done. And then I did something that was subtle in the last video. This video, I think I'm going to do something where it's out of my MAC palette so that if there's any colors or anything that you like that you want to grab and you have like a local MAC counter nearby, you can grab it. So the last palette, I did something that was a lot of pinks and roses, and it was something that I got during Christmas, and not everybody could have that. A lot of the colors are complementary to some of the colors that you can find in Too Faced, Urban Decay, MAC, so I'm sure you can find the similar colors, but this time I'm just going to go ahead and use my MAC palette so that if you have a Macy's or a JCPenney or anything like that that sells MAC at the counters, I don't know if it's sold at JCPenney or not. But point being, you can go to the counter again. So the first shade I'm using, I think, is Bamboo, but I'm not positive. And I'm just going to put that in my crease. And I'm just using my Sigma E40 brush. I'm just blending this all over my lid crease, not trying to be precise at all. It's just my transition shade. The next color I am going to be using is going to be this warmer color here mixed with this one here. And again, I will tell you the colors, whatever they are, below. I'm sorry, I don't have them popped out, but didn't pre-plan. Shame on me. And you'll notice two of my colors are missing. The last time I traveled, I broke them. So I finally, just the other day, filled up my palette and was so proud of myself that I had all my own MAC shadows. So I'll be replacing those, but I'm not sure with what yet. And I'm just carving in my crease with this color. The next color I'm going to use is, oh, and it was with the E25 blending brush. Next brush I'm using is the Ulta Professionals shader brush. And I'm going to be using Naked Lunch all over the lid. Actually, let's see if it was that easy. So my first shade that I used was, in fact, Bamboo. And I mixed it with Soft Brown and Saddle. Here we go. Okay, so these are not as hard to get out as I thought they were. So I am mixing it with Naked Lunch at the moment. I'm sorry, using Naked Lunch all over the lid at the moment. I'm just blending. I didn't put any extra color on. I'm just using whatever's left over on the product, just to kind of, or on the product, on the brush, whatever product is left on the brush, and just kind of blending that across the top in the crease, just to kind of blend it out and not have harsh lines. Then I am going to take my pencil brush, and what color is this? It's Folly. I am just going to right in the corner. Tapping off the excess. Don't blow on your brushes. I've said it in another video. It's not good. Don't do as I do. I am a terrible example. As far as brushes go. I don't do it on my clients. I only do it at home. I don't know why I have that bad habit. Gotta break it. And I am only putting this in the outer corner of my eye and in the crease. And now I am blending again with my E25 this time instead of my E40. And I am doing it this way, not this way. Oh man, after using this product in all these browns and pinks, it looks terrible. My brushes are getting a bath tonight. It's Wash Wednesday anyway, so. Okay. So, last but not least, I'm going to use, what is this? A shader lid. I'm going to use my Bath & Body Works that has no name, and then I'm like 90% sure, you can't get it anymore, just a bamboo. And then my last color that I am going to use is going to be in my crease, or my tear duct, is going to be MAC Nylon. I don't even have to, I've hit pan on this whole thing. It's my all-time favorite highlight, and it's just going into my tear duct. Brighten that up. And then I'll take it right along the waterline to make me look more opaque. And then I will put it on my brow. I don't like a harsh look like that on the brow bone too much, so I always blend it out. I'm getting ready to do brows. And you'll notice I have not used concealer in the last two videos. It is because I have lost my MAC concealer. And I have attempted to use some of the ones that I've gotten in my beauty boxes and stuff, and I hate them. I would rather not use a concealer than the crap that I have in my house right now. I will be going to get some new concealer soon, but unfortunately, I have not been to the mall. Okay, so I could stop here and have a nice, simple look. Or I can go the extra mile, and it doesn't have to be Makeup Geek. I don't actually have any glitter pigments by MAC, or else I would say to use some of the glitter pigments by MAC. Glitter pigments by MAC, but I don't have any. So I have a lot of pigments by Makeup Geek, and I'm going to use one that I did not pay for. I got it for free, but I won it. It was not sent to me as PR. I won it in a contest on Instagram. They are not paying me. I just absolutely love it because I love Makeup Geek, so obviously I had entered into the contest. I hate, hate, hate their packaging. It gets all over everything every time I open these. So that is one thing I will say, is that I cannot stand their packaging for these glitter pigments. They are the worst. But for that extra glam for Valentine's Day, you can pop on some glitter for going out. And the color I am using, I will pick up in just a second after I've put the cap back on this. They need a sifter or something. It is all over everything again. I think I would wear it more because I love how pretty it is. I mean, look at that. I love it. But I hate the mess. I hate it. There is a rumor that they are getting sifters or something, and I swear, I really truly hope that they sell it to anybody that bought the product outright or even won the product outright before the sifters were on this product, because it is a bloody nightmarish mess. So now I have my eyes have glitter. I'm gonna go ahead and just right along the bottom, not adding any extra product, just kind of running along whatever's left from when I had the, what is this called? Folly on it. I think it was called Folly. Folly! Yes. Oh, fudge. My hands are a bloody mess. So I am going to use, for my inner eyeliner, I'm using Stomper, which is a brown and not a black. Another bad habit that I have is pulling on my waterline, like I'm doing right now. It is not a good habit, and if you don't have it, don't start it, and if you do, do anything and everything you can to break it. Here, I'm even trying to break it now. Okay, and then eyeshadow done, glitter done, eyeliner done. So time for mascara. And I am using the Jelly Pong Pong Fairy Lashes, same as my last video, because I don't feel like going and finding a different mascara. Where I film and where I store my makeup are in two completely different rooms. So I try to grab everything I'm going to possibly be interested in using when filming up front. But that doesn't mean I know what I'm going to do. I'm kind of just grabbing whatever it is that looks fun to me. Okay. So, mascara is on. This would be a great time to use false lashes if you have some. I have some. I'm not using them because I think the only thing I am worse at than liquid liner is false lashes. I am practicing in the background so that someday I can actually come on here and do a good job. That, or perhaps I will try and do a get ready with me where you can laugh at me as I attempt to put on false lashes. We shall see. But in the meantime, we are going to just move on. So I'm going to use the, what is this? Here we go. The Emphasize powder to brighten up my under eye area. If I had concealer, I'd say we were setting the under eye area, but we don't. And I don't. So if you have concealer, this would have been where you would have dabbed on and done all of that beautiful conceal work. But my laziness. And then for my contour powder or shading powder, oh come on, what color are you? Dug my nail on that, is Shadester by MAC. Like I said, I'm just trying to do something that you can pretty much, I don't know if you can get Shadester, I think you can get Shadester and Emphasize. I don't think you can get, I know you can get them in the pans or the pots for the eyeshadows, and I'm not positive about the Emphasize and Shadester for powders as far as being able to, I don't know how they come. I just got the pans and I ordered them online once upon a time when I was trying to get free shipping, funny enough. Need a bath. I'm trying to lighten up the red around my nose. Normally I would put concealer there, but oh. I miss my concealer. I miss it. It has grown legs, and it was brand new too. That's the worst part. That's the other half. Is I'm keep like holding out, hoping, but. My blush today is going to be Modern Mandarin, and I'm going to mix that with, oh, I just dug my nail in this again. Oh, fudge, I liked this one. Modern Mandarin and Margin are what I'm going to mix today. So it's going to be a peachy shadow for spring. Just in my mind, thinking spring is right around the corner. It's a little bit too peach, so I'm going to mix that with Berry Pop by Clinique. It's another one that you can just go to the counter and get. Oh yeah, that brings down that peach nicely. A little bit darker than I wanted. Using my the Starlit palette by Bare Minerals. I'm cutting it close on time. It's gonna give me a suntanned look and blend out this hot mess that I made with my blushes because I couldn't choose a color. So that actually just gave me a tan, which it's an all-over body bronzer and you can tan, so that's exactly what it just did. It kind of gave me a tan, like I went to the Caribbean, so be it. And then I am going to use a red lip, I think. It's a Frenchie, possibly. I don't know if this is the color I want to use, actually. Not sure I'm sticking with this color. I might go get a different one. Yeah. This is too bright. When I grabbed it, I thought I was grabbing a different one. This is too bright. I'll be back. I'm gonna get a different shade. Okay, so I just removed the color that I originally put on my lips, which was Frenchie. I don't think I meant to grab that. So I am now going to go in with MAC Brick as my lip liner. And then I'm going to use my all-time favorite lipstick, and it's by Besame. And tell me that this packaging isn't just beautiful. They come in these little velvet tube sleeves, and then the packaging is just this gold, oh, fuzzy, a gold bullet. And then it opens up, and you have the old-fashioned wedge type. And they're just so creamy and buttery and just absolutely amazing. And this is in the color Red Velvet C215. So it's just like a blue-red. And I still have some of the neon color that I see from when I like scrubbed that off my lips just a moment ago. So that looks bad, but yeah, I like this coloration. I just think that red lips on Valentine's Day are just so fun. So that is what I would actually wear out on Valentine's Day night. if I wasn't going to be camping, because my perfect weekend is to go hiking and camping and be outdoors and just a little bit different than some people's ideal. But yeah, if I was going to be going to a nice dinner, I think this would be pretty much the look I would go for. Something that's a pink neutral eye with a little bit of glitter and glitz, and then just a bold red lip. I love a bold red lip. And again, I'm getting texts and calls and everything else. Again, I'm not popular until I film. So a bold red lip. And then just to finish off, even though I used emphasize, I want to just do a little bit more on the cheeks for a highlight. And then just champagne pop right on the cheeks, just to give that nice little highlight. And that completes this look. If you found this to be entertaining and want to see more like this or more videos with me in them, make sure you give it a thumbs up and you make sure to subscribe below so that you can get notifications every time I post. Until next time, bye guys! Okay, so I just removed the color that I originally put on my lips, which was Frenchie. I don't think I meant to grab that. So I am now going to go in with MAC Brick as my lip liner. And then I'm going to use my all-time favorite lipstick, and it's by Besame. And tell me that this packaging isn't just beautiful. They come in these little velvet tube sleeves, and then the packaging is just this gold, a gold bullet. And then it opens up, and you have the old-fashioned wedge type. And they're just so creamy and buttery and just absolutely amazing. And this is in the color Red Velvet C215. So it's just like a blue-red. And I still have some of the neon color that I see from when I like scrubbed that off my lips just a moment ago. So that looks bad, but yeah, I like this coloration. I just think that red lips on Valentine's Day are just so fun. So that is what I would actually wear out on Valentine's Day night if I wasn't going to be camping, because my perfect weekend is to go hiking and camping and be outdoors and just a little bit different than some people's ideal. But yeah, if I was going to be going to a nice dinner, I think this would be pretty much the look I would go for. Something that's a pink neutral eye with a little bit of glitter and glitz, and then just a bold red lip. I love a bold red lip. And again, I'm getting and calls and everything else. Again, I'm not popular until I film. So a bold red lip. And then just to finish off, even though I used Emphasize, I want to just do a little bit more on the cheeks for a highlight. And then just champagne pop right on the cheeks, just to give that nice little highlight. And that completes this look. If you guys enjoyed it and you found this entertaining, or you want to see more like this, please make sure you subscribe below. And until next time, bye guys! Thank you for watching. I screw that up every time. If you found this to be entertaining and want to see more like this or more videos with me in them, make sure you give it a thumbs up and you make sure to subscribe below so that you can get notifications every time I post. Until next time, bye guys! And we're done. Okay, so I just removed the color that I originally put on my lips, which was Frenchie. I don't think I meant to grab that. So I am now going to go in with MAC Brick as my lip liner. And then I'm going to use my all-time favorite lipstick, and it's by Besame. And tell me that this packaging isn't just beautiful. They come in these little velvet tube sleeves, and then the packaging is just this gold, a gold bullet. And then it opens up, and you have the old-fashioned wedge type. And they're just so creamy and buttery and just absolutely amazing. And this is in the color Red Velvet C215. So it's just like a blue red. And I still have some of the neon color that I see from when I like scrubbed that off my lips just a moment ago. So that looks bad, but yeah, I like this coloration. I just think that red lips on Valentine's Day are just so fun. So that is what I would actually wear out on Valentine's Day night if I wasn't going to be camping, because my perfect weekend is to go hiking and camping and be outdoors and just a little bit different than some people's ideal. But yeah, if I was going to be going to a nice dinner, I think this would be pretty much the look I would go for. Something that's a pink neutral eye with a little bit of glitter and glitz, and then just a bold red lip. I love a bold red lip. And again, I'm getting texts and calls and everything else. Again, I'm not popular until I film. So a bold red lip, and then just to finish off, even though I used Emphasize, I want to just do a little bit more on the cheeks for a highlight. And then just champagne pop right on the cheeks, just to give that nice little highlight. And that completes this look. If you guys enjoyed it and you found this entertaining, or you want to see more like this, please make sure you subscribe below. And until next time, bye guys! Thank you for watching. I screw that up every time. If you found this to be entertaining and want to see more like this or more videos with me in them, make sure you give it a thumbs up and you make sure to subscribe below so that you can get notifications every time I post. Until next time, bye guys! And we're done.